Welcome to the Bureau of Meteorology's Severe Weather Outlook for October 2019 to April 2020. Although severe weather can occur at any time of the year, this period is the peak time for bushfires, heatwaves, flooding, tropical cyclones and severe thunderstorms. In the months ahead, Australia can expect an increased risk of heatwaves, elevated bushfire potential, particularly in the east, fewer than average tropical cyclones, a lower risk of widespread flooding, and a near-normal outlook for severe thunderstorms. Large parts of Australia are extremely dry as we head into the warmer months, especially in the east, where some areas have seen very little rain now for 3 years. This year, our nation's January to September rainfall was the fourth lowest on record and the lowest since 1965. 2019 has also been exceptionally warm, with our daytime temperatures so far this year tracking as the highest on record. We expect the warm and dry trend to continue for the remainder of the year. This increases the risk of severe weather in some regions, but reduces it in others. Let's step through the outlook. Heatwaves are Australia's most deadly severe weather. Warm nights after hot days give our bodies little chance to cool down, and heat stress becomes a real risk to human health. Heatwaves also have a significant impact on our economy, with agriculture, energy management, infrastructure, and other industry all affected. This summer, there's a higher chance of extreme heat developing across our inland, with soils so dry and an outlook for clearer skies. This raises the risk of heatwaves for much of southern and eastern Australia when winds push this heat towards the coast. Just like last year, it's been an early start to the fire season for many, with bushfires already in Queensland and New South Wales during August and September. Through the remainder of the fire season, the dry landscape in the east and southwest Western Australia means that any warm and windy weather will increase the fire risk, particularly along the coast and through elevated areas. Australia sees around 11 tropical cyclones on average each year, with 4 crossing our coast. This year, we're expecting fewer tropical cyclones than average. This is usually indicated when we see higher than normal air pressure across northern Australia, which has been the case over recent months. Remember though, Australia has never had a season without a coastal crossing, and cyclones are not evenly spread throughout the season. And what the seasonal outlook can't predict is the size, intensity, or exact location of where any one cyclone may form. This means communities right across northern Australia need to stay prepared throughout the cyclone season. The chance of widespread riverine flooding is reduced in the months ahead. Where the land is dry and rivers are low, rain first soaks into soils before filling rivers. This explains the outlook for lower than average flows through rivers in many catchments. And whilst Indian Ocean patterns suggest a later than normal arrival for the first rains of this year's northern wet season, localised major flooding can occur in any northern wet season. This is especially the case with slow moving tropical lows, which can cause widespread rainfall and dangerous flooding, even in areas that have been previously dry. We saw this last wet season with historic floods across northern and central Queensland during January and February. Some places received more than 2 metres of rain in just 10 days as the monsoon trough and a slow-moving tropical low set in. Severe thunderstorms are dangerous because of their potential for flash flooding, large hail, damaging winds, and sometimes tornadoes. Severe thunderstorms are more common during the warmer months, particularly in northern New South Wales, southern Queensland, inland Western Australia, and across the tropical north. Across southern Australia, the risk of heavy rain with severe thunderstorms increases when humidity and moisture extend across the continent from tropical weather systems. Thunderstorm asthma can also be triggered by severe thunderstorms, especially from October to December, when pollen levels are highest. So, with the fire season already underway and cyclone season just around the corner, now's the time to actively prepare for the months ahead. As we all know, Australia's weather can change quickly, so it's important to follow advice from emergency services on what to do before, during, and after severe weather. Stay up to date with the latest forecasts and warnings on the Bureau's website, and keep an eye out for our weather update videos throughout the coming months.